Hey, tell you guys a little more about it.
Great.
Thank you. So, Sealights, continuous testing platform. I've actually really enjoyed listening to your presentation. Me, Cater, great developers just like yourself. And I'm looking forward to starting to use this Ironman technology myself. So, what we do at Sealights is we built a platform for CTOs, VPRNDs, QA managers to aggregate all the information and data from their different testing tools and see it on one dashboard, one stop shop, where they can actually understand their testing code coverage and understand if they have high quality code, if they have any missed, if they've missed any parts of their code and they haven't tested it, they have untested code that's going to go into production. And today, the CI/CD process, continuous integration and delivery, has become the de facto process for all developers. And without being able to release new updates on a daily basis, you are not relevant in today's world. The problem is, the bottleneck is testing. The tools that are currently available are not able to test quickly enough, and managers are not able to aggregate the data quickly enough and understand where they stand. I'll jump right into our platform right now. What you see is the Sealights platform. You can see it is built centered. So we use microservices. We have about 30 of those. We work with Node and AWS. And every one of these lines, it's a microservice. There are many testing management platforms today in the market that can show you unit test coverage, but no platform can show you functional test code coverage, integration test code coverage, API test code coverage, and the overall code coverage of your application. And that's what Sealights does. This is the last build. We use our Sealights ourselves. This is our own production environment, and you can see that right now we have a build that was deployed today. The number of tests that this build has overdone, the fail test, the skip tests, another point that nobody else can show you. Developers sometimes skip tests, it might fail their build, and you don't want that happening. And as a manager, you want to know that. And the aggregated code coverage of all of your application. What you see here are our environments. We have a history of all the builds that went into the Sealights platform and then into production. And this is the history of all the builds up here. This gives us the ability to compare to the previous build, and we actually can see the overall code coverage for every build that's in production. The unit test it went through, the sanity lab we have, we use integration tests after unit tests, and quality goals. Quality goals are a very important use case that I want to stop a little bit and touch on some more. Quality goals are inside jargon for untested code changes that might go into production. The way Sealights works is we're a cloud-based platform. There are two components that you need to download, and in under an hour you start seeing value. One is our code scanner. It scans the code on every build that is going to go into production. We are not sitting on your source code. We only have metadata, the names of your tests. The other one is the test listener. We listen to the tests that are being invoked and correlating them with the code in every build using dynamic instrumentation. You are able to know exactly which code was tested and which wasn't tested. If there's a piece of code that wasn't touched by any test, any lab, unit, integration, API, we give you an alert. A quality hole is going to go into production. And this part of the code that was changed is probably because the client asked for it, right? Maybe you had an update, a version update. This is code that's going to be scrutinized, and it's very important for you to know about that. We have a Slack integration, and on your Slack channel, you get these notifications of exactly which developer did the change and why the whole has happened, and you can stop that.